a cop, a police officer, killed two teens. That's the cop. He killed two teenagers. They're dead. They're no more. It was in a police chase. Let's put up the teenagers that he killed. Those teenagers should be alive. This happened in Louisiana. Police officer is facing charges. He was arrested following the deadly crash. This was a high speed chase, went through several communities. These teenagers, Maggie Dunn, 17, and Caroline Gill, 15, they were killed because of the criminal negligence of this cop. They went to Brusly High School. They were cheerleaders. Let's put up the man responsible again. His name is David Cauthron, was charged for two counts of negligent homicide, one count of negligent injury. Exactly a week after his arrest, guess what? They let him out of jail, $100,000 bond, no problem. Let me give you background on what happened. Official said the chase began in Baton Rouge and made his way to West Baton Rouge Parish before coming to an inn on the interstate back in Baton Rouge. The pursuit led to a crash on LA1 in Brusly and left two teens dead and a backseat passenger injured. The teen victims, Dunn and Gill, were students at Brusly High School. Officials added. The DA, Tony Clayton, said his office is looking into actions of the officer and his role, the crash and pursuit. The officer has been identified, as I just noted. He was arrested and booked into the West Baton Rouge Parish Prison at 9:45 p.m. Sunday, charged with two counts of negligent homicide, one count of negligent injuring. Clayton said the officer's bond had been set at $100,000. $100,000 for two dead children is what they said it at. Okay. Clayton said the police chief, Richard Anderson, told him the officer is currently on administrative leave. Clayton also plans to convene a grand jury at the end of the month to look into the officer's actions. To celebrate this new year with my family, and for those families not to be able to celebrate with those kids is just despicable. And whoever will be held accountable for it will be held accountable for it, period, Clayton said. I'm going to give you some background as to what led to this. So this is according to the Baton Rouge Police Department. All right, this is their narrative. All right, according to the Baton Rouge Police Department, the pursuit was the result of a home invasion that occurred in Baton Rouge. That's where Taquil Sanders, 24, allegedly broke into a family member's home and stole their car. Arrest documents revealed that the officers later tried to pull Sanders over during a traffic stop on River Road. The document said that when Sanders refused to stop, that's when the chase began. Sanders is accused of running several red lights and reaching speeds of 110 miles per hour on the interstate, according to the arrest document. Now, typically, every single police department, they have an internal policy, and sometimes states have a statutory requirement where cops cannot pursue if it creates danger for the local community. You gotta call the helicopter now. You gotta call other jurisdictions. You gotta do something other than kill people in the process of arresting one. All right, Jackson, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, plain and simple, the end result of it being two dead teenagers, he clearly wasn't taking the types of protocol necessary for an officer of safety. You know, he wasn't thinking about any of this. So this is pure negligence. There's really nothing else to say about it in terms of like what might be going on here. Yeah. The guy wasn't being careful. He wasn't thinking. He was in Rambo mode and he crashed and he killed two little girls. So, I mean, unfortunately, this is routine, but I mean, I really don't have anything else to say except we know what he did.
And this story hit me. My daughter is 16. You have 15, 17, and they're dead. They are victims of out of control policing. Who would put individuals at risk like this other than a cop? All right, we're gonna continue to follow. I do believe these charges will be enhanced after the grand jury presentation. I'll bring you that as it comes.